Hey, y'all, we're back this week. Before we get started, I just want to kind of give everybody a reminder that we're looking forward to seeing y'all in June in Tupelo. It's going to be the 9th through the 13th. Me and Teresa will be there starting on the 9th through the 13th. And Mom and Dad, y'all are going to be down on the 11th. Is that correct? And 11th. Also, Danielle, Nolan, and Lainey will be down on the 11th. And Joey and Ruth Ann's still kind of undetermined. He may or may not.
Yeah.
But he said if he doesn't, he's really going to miss y'all and tell everybody, hey. And, of course, he'll probably send you something on a video.
Yeah.
And the same with Dakota and Jenny. It just depends on their work and stuff. But
yeah, Joey has to be on out of town on a training thing for police department. So.
But we're going to be down there sometime or another. We're going to be the date's between the 9th and 13th, but we'll be in front of the Tupelo Hardware Store.
I live in Tupelo.
y'all don't get started. But anyway, like I said, I'm getting excited, looking forward to seeing y'all, and then, of course, as August gets closer, we'll let you know about that. So let's get started with some more questions.
I can't get over the Tupelo.
Okay, my tongue got twisted.
Okay, Billy, this is from Keith DeBorn.
Okay,
Billy. And he wants to know what your favorite picture of you taken with Elvis and a story behind it.
Hell, you got to be kidding, man. Every picture with me with Elvis is my favorite, you know. I mean, with Elvis? All of them. From a kid to... You know.
Yeah, I couldn't say
you like one any better.
Not any better, man. It'd be hard to pick one out particularly.
Yeah.
The story behind
the
way what I've been there.
I like the one of you with his medals.
Okay,
I interrupted.
Okay, I'm sorry.
No, I interrupted.
Well, I'm still sorry.
I'm sorry. Remember what I told you in the last video?
I know, that's what I'm thinking.
I like the one of you when you're looking at his medals. And I like the one of you on the bumper cars.
Yeah, I hadn't got over that.
And I like the one with you at the studio with him, with Danny on the leash.
Yeah.
That's for you, Chris.
Yeah.
and I could go on.
Oh, I can say a Scatter must have been one good-looking monkey, boy.
Well.
But do you have any story behind anyone that you like?
God.
Or all of
with
them?
Scatter?
No.
Yeah. Great monkey.
I met Scatter for the first time, I think I was 14. And we had gone to a Graceland school where they were playing. I was dating Billy. And we had gone up to the school for Billy was going to play football out on the playground. And Alan Portis had Scatter on a leash. And we had stopped and gotten a hot dog or something.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And I had a Coke or a drink in my hand. And Billy was playing with Scatter. And I leaned down to look at him. And he said, and took my hot dog. And that was all I wanted to see of Scatter. But he was something else.
He was. But a lot of stories about
There's
Scatter.
A whole bunch of stories about Scatter that goes on and on and on.
Yeah, and we'll get to some
get
of those.
To some of them, yeah.
And Scatter was an alcoholic. We'll have to tell about that, too.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that was...
so much for the alcoholic.
Yeah, that was for Keith.
Buy me a drink.
Okay, this is for Nick C. Did anyone do any damage to Elvis's cars?
I know
Elvis did. He shot one of them.
Yeah, he did a lot of damage to him, but nobody except a couple happened. One of them was totaled by one of the guys.
One of the guys that drove it.
Which was it was an accident.
Yeah,
anybody. yeah. I didn't want to tell it, but I will.
Forced, huh?
Forced into it. We went to the studio. Well, Elvis got up.
Oh, you did?
He was mad. something didn't go right, you know. Anyway, all the way there, we're in the Rolls Royce limousine and all, and
I forgot about
that. He pulled up, you know, and all that, and he rant and raved the whole time. We was driving to the studio, and we got there, and he opened the door and slammed it back. Well, I was getting out on the same side he was, and that sucker hit me on the leg, and I thought, oh, my God, and before I thought, because he was, you know, already in the dressing room, I kicked it and sprung that door. And after I come to my senses, I realized, oh, no. So I thought, oh, what in the world am I going to do? So Allison, he said, I'll cover it. He said, you know, I'll take it to the dealership down here and see if I can get it, you know, back right before, you know, the end of the day. And thank goodness they did. Boy, you talking about somebody sweating bullets, but I was. You know. But anyway, but other than that, never any fans ever damaged the car. They, I mean, that was like, you know, a definite no. In fact, they had hurt somebody who tried to damage one of them, you know. So.
They never, and maybe you know that, I never knew of any damage around the property of Grayson, really. I mean,
no.
You just didn't, I mean, they didn't.
They were protective of him.
Right.
They were so protective of anything.
They would jump on.
Yeah. And I'm sorry. But anyway, somebody also asked the same question on there about the pink Cadillac. Did you see that on there?
Yes, I did.
Yes.
The question was, where was it taken after it burned up? I'm going to see who. Here it is.
Yes, right there.
I don't know how to, E-I-O, I-O?
We're going to try our best,
I-O
or E-O.
It's all to work.
We appreciate the question,
that's
but
not yeah. Right. It's not,
where did the burn,
I'm sorry, I'm just playing.
Where did the burned up pink Cadillac end up?
In the junkyard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it really?
Well, yeah.
Was it towed somewhere special? Do you have
no.
Junkyard?
Yeah, junkyard. Yeah, it burned it up. The story behind that is, I think most everybody probably heard it. They were on tour. Elvis had a pink Cadillac at that time. It was a little lighter than the one he had for his mama, and it had a black top. And they had put all the instruments on top and all. And anyway, the brake drums of it got real hot and somehow caught the fluid on fire and naturally set flame to the truck part of it. And anyway, they realized what was going on and they jumped out and got the instruments off the top. By then it really had covered a whole lot of territory and, you know, the gas tanks back in were in the back of the car too. So it got on down and anyway, it burned it completely up and they just
That was a
junkyard. Very, very lucky for them,
mm-hmm.
You know, as far as, but yeah, that's.
Do you remember what kind of car that was that one of the guys totaled? Because he'll probably ask.
I think it was the Stutz.
One of the Stutz. I think had, that's what I was thinking too, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, one of the first ones he had was.
Yeah, because there.
No. Yeah, it was, and I think they tried to reconstruct it. Anyway, I know they brought it back to Graceland.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's the one that was covered up, wasn't it?
It was covered up for a long time.
Was it a white one?
No, black.
Black. Well, I know that a rumor got out that
but it
Billy
damaged,
had
frame damage
a wheel and all that came from the Stutz that he had up for sale, and that's not true. That is totally untrue. That wasn't. Okay, this is from Bonnie Brown. Did Priscilla have a wedding shower and baby shower? And if so, did Joe go to it, attend it? And yes, I did, and she did, and all the wives and girlfriends. I was the one picked to drive.
This was a baby shower, wasn't it?
It was her baby shower. And we, Nancy Sinatra, had the baby shower for her. And we all went together. I picked everybody up, the girls that went, and we went to Nancy's house, and she's was just a really nice lady, and her mother was there. I loved her mother, and her mother was telling about things then that was available that she didn't have when Nancy and her brother were born. So we had a blast at her house.
Excuse me.
I remember she had a picture of Tommy Sands, and we always thought, you know, Tommy Sands was great back then too. We didn't say it around Elvis, but you know.
Not but he was.
He was.
I mean, I think I told about it in another video of meeting Tommy Sands.
He was nice.
He come into town, and he wanted to go to one of the restaurants that Elvis went to and all, and Anita Wood was in contact with him and all. And anyway, we met him at Chenault's.
Nancy was not married to him, though, at the time she gave the shower for Priscilla.
Did y'all play any games at the baby shower or have special food?
No, actually, we just we talked, and they had a lot of food and a lot of, you know, just there wasn't a lot of time. There were other people. I remember Michael Landon's wife was there, and some other, a lot of, yeah. A lot of hen cackling going. There was a lot of celebrities' wives that were there, and back then men didn't go to the baby showers like they do now, so it was just all women. But
dang.
I know Patsy Gamble and Richard's wife and then and Joan Esposito. Sandy Schilling. Yeah, just the wives and girlfriends, and it was nice.
Hey, who needs his wife?
But it was, yeah, that was nice. And
now, believe it or not, I can't be serious when I want to. This is just not the time.
Oh, I've got to answer this.
Yeah, we got time for one.
This
more.
Is Joy Timothy. Did Joe ever cook for Elvis? And did he come over and eat with you? He used to come out to our trailer all the time, and he snacked, but he didn't eat meals like everybody else did. He ate mostly at home. He didn't. But in Palm Springs, I did fix him an omelet. And I always fix peanut butter and banana, fried peanut butter and banana sandwiches. That's how we got started on them from the maids out in California. But I did fix those for him. But this time he wanted, and we didn't have maids in Palm Springs. We just go there on the spur of the moment. And usually, I mean, I've washed his pajamas and Lisa's clothes and our clothes and, you know, get them out of the dryer and all that. We just, you know, just played it as it came along. But I did fix him an omelet. And after I got through with it, it was me and Al Strada in the kitchen, and Billy and all them were out sitting in the living room with Elvis, and Al took the omelet out. And Al brought the omelet back. And he said, nope, he couldn't eat that.
So, yeah, I can't eat this.
I can't eat this. This doesn't look right.
No, you can say shit.
One omelet that I did. So I had to fix another one because he wanted it. He didn't want it scrambled up. He wanted it turned and it looking just like an omelet. So Al had to help me, and we finally battered it together and got it fixed and took it back out, and he took that one. So there's a lot of my cooking skills.
You just don't know.
We made it. We made it.
Matzo ball soup.
Oh, God. I got to tell this one. This is the funniest thing. We had been to Las Vegas. And
Las Vegas. Don't Las say Vegas. Nothing about me. Vegas. He said Las Vegas.
Las Vegas.
Las Vegas.
That's we like had at the Aladdin Hotel.
And we had, believe it or not, Marty got us in.
Marty got us started on it. It was delicious.
Matzo ball soup, and they brought it, and, you know, and it was like China peas and little matzo balls and all, and it was really good, you know. So Joe said, you know, that was so good. We got back to Los Angeles there, and we was living in our apartment at that time. And she said, you know, I could make that. And I said, hey, well, make us some. So she decided she would. So
I got some matzo meal.
Yeah.
Marty to get me some matzo meal
and some chata peas and several other things that went in it and
bean sprouts.
And she made the
chicken.
Yeah, and did you add yeast to it?
No.
The matzo ball anyway.
I started out with the matzo balls the size they were supposed to be. Mm-hmm. But
as time went on, we sat down, we was watching TV, and kept hearing something go, poof! And I thought, what in the heck is that? So it kept doing it. I thought somebody was maybe, you know, from the lower, we was on the upper level, and I thought maybe it was too loud or something. Somebody was bumping
the floor.
And so I got up, and I go to looking around. Well, I went into the kitchen, and on the floor was matzo balls that damn big. Boom! And they were rolling out of the pan and hitting the floor. And I said, Joe, I didn't know we were having dinner on the floor tonight. But believe me, you don't want her.
I'm never cooking for you again.
You don't never want her to make matzo ball soup.
Oh, I can make it now. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you turned out to be a good cook.
I did. I've had.
That was funny though.
Although we had to make it. We had to make it through the early years.
The early years, yeah. Was a, I should tell about the radar range Elvis got me for my birthday.
Oh no.
We'll save that.
We got another one, but we'll save it.
Yeah, but we'll save it. Anyway, that's something.
Getting back to
y'all, we want to say that we really appreciate all the views, all the questions. Keep them coming. And remember, if you hadn't subscribed, hit that subscribe.
Wait a minute. You got to say one thing, and I want to say get well to Marv Blankenship.
Yes, we love you, Marv. And with that, what do we always say?
We always love Elvis.